Is Zane ever here?
I'm gonna be a regular Pepsi, a Diet Pepsi, a caffeine free Pepsi, Diet Pepsi. I think we have a little bit of drama, a little bit of horror, some comedy, some song and dance, special guest star appearances, and last but not least, Thelma Linden. So we hope you enjoy this tape. You're welcome to get on there. Hello, Mr. Arnold. My name is Dr. Munster Hosting, and today I'm going to do a word association test. I'm going to tell you a word, and you tell me the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear that word, okay?
Okay.
Okay, what comes to your mind when you hear the word tennis?
Douglas.
What comes to your mind when you hear swimming pool?
Douglas.
What about Arizona?
Douglas.
Grand Canyon?
Douglas.
What about RV?
Douglas.
What about the Army?
Douglas.
What about West Virginia?
Douglas.
What about Thrift?
Douglas.
And what about Methodist?
Douglas.
And what about Mother?
Douglas.
Well, Mr. Arnold, I can professionally say that you have one thing on your mind.
I know there's a couple blondes out there, so I have a blonde joke. There was this blonde and her friend was a brunette. They went to this party. And, of course, the guys were telling blonde jokes. And the blonde got a little upset because she said to her brunette friend, she says, "Us blondes aren't that dumb. And it really upsets me to hear these guys telling jokes about blondes." So the brunette said, "Well, why don't you do something intelligent, and the next party you can come back at them?" And the blonde said, that's great. What could I do? So her brunette friend says, why don't you study and learn all the capitals of the United States? And then the next party, you can name the capitals. And the blonde said, this is great. So for weeks and weeks and weeks, the blonde studied the geographical United States as he studied all the capitals. So several more weeks went by, and then finally another party came. So her, the blonde, and the brunette friend goes to the party. And sure enough, the guys start telling blonde jokes and talking about how dumb blondes are. So the blonde says, we're not so dumb. She says, I know all the capitals of the United States. So the guy says, well, I tell you what, tell me the capital of Montana. And about that time, the blonde threw her hair back, and she goes, M?
Hello, Mrs. Arnold. My name is Dr. Munster Holstein. And today we're going to have a word association test, which is I will tell you a word, and you tell me the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear that word.
Okay.
What comes to your mind when you hear the word Germany?
That's stuff.
Okay. What comes to your mind when you hear the word angel?
That's stuff.
Okay. What comes to your mind when you hear the word Illinois?
That's stuff.
Okay. What comes to your mind when you hear the word army?
That's stuff.
And what about Eloy?
That's stuff.
And what about RV?
That's stuff.
What about piano?
Esta?
Okay. What about Clippinger?
Esta.
Okay. Well, Mrs. Arnold, in my professional opinion, as I told another patient of mine, you basically have one thing in your mind, on your mind, and you need a lot of help. Okay, and now a word from our sponsor.
Ladies and gentlemen,
can I ask you a question? How is your tennis game? Well, you must need the Van Meter 2000. Ladies and gentlemen, Andre Agassi is who he is today because of the Van Meter 2000. It is available in all sporting goods stores today. Wow, nice shot, Mark. Caddy, hand me my 3-iron. No, Caddy, my 3-iron. Caddy, 3-iron. Mark, where do you find these caddies? Here, an iron. Hand me my iron. McCormick, Van Meter, Holstein, Ledman. Today I'm going to do a word association test, which is I will give you a word and you tell me the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear that word, okay? What comes to your mind when you hear the word fast food?
Douglas.
Okay. What comes to your mind when you hear the word stained glass? What about a pillow? Okay, what comes to your mind when you hear the word army?
Repeat that, please.
What comes to your mind when you hear the word army?
Doctor.
All right, okay. And what comes to your mind when you hear the word Germany?
Marvin.
Okay. And what comes your mind when you hear the word apple?
Douglas.
Okay, and what about, what comes to your mind when you hear the word bed?
Lemon.
Okay, Miss Lemon, like I told a couple other patients of mine, you, definitely have, one or two things on your mind, and, you need a lot of help.
Hey, my name is Seaver Kendner. A lot of people call me Bill. I'm making new squirrel trap. Well, I think I'm a rabbit house, whatever it is, about catching squirrels. I got one over in Washington, D.C. right now. Try it out. I heard they caught two squirrels last week. So you can see I got one in here now, but the door didn't go down. He must not have pulled the trap in the back of the nut, a peanut in the back. When you pull a peanut, he'd drop it. I got the squirrel in there.
Did he get it?
I got him. One squirrel. But he's not supposed to be dead.
Okay, Mrs. Kinder. My name is Dr. Munster Holstein, and today we're going to have a word association test, which is basically I will give you a word or phrase, and you tell me the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear that word or phrase, okay? So what comes to your mind when you hear Berlin?
Berlin.
Connie. Okay. What about Virginia?
Connie.
And quilt?
Connie.
What comes to your mind when you hear stained glass?
Connie.
What about Rose? Gravel yard.
Oh, Connie.
What about large pool table?
Connie.
What about Germany?
Connie.
And one last word, Arizona.
Connie.
Okay, well, Mrs. Kinder, I can safely say, like I told a couple other patients of mine, that you have one thing on your mind.
Make my dreams come true. For
found out? If so, you need the Van Meter 2000, the tennis racket of the future today. Available in all sporting goods stores. The Van Meter 2000.
Yes.
Yeah, it's the same song.
What should we sing next?
Well, let's see. How about this one? I wish I was an apple.
That's a good one.
Hanging on a tree. And every time my sweetheart passed, she'd take a bite of me. She told me that she loved me. She called me Sugar Plum. She threw her arms around me. I thought my time had come.
Get along home, Cindy, Cindy. Get along home, Cindy, Cindy. Get along home, Cindy, Cindy. I'll marry you sometime.
I wish I had a needle as fine as I could sew. I sew her in my pocket, and down the road I go. Cindy hugged and kissed me. She swung her head and cried. Swore I was prettiest thing that ever lived or died.
Get along home, Cindy, Cindy. Get along home, Cindy, Cindy. Get along home, Cindy, Cindy. I'll marry you sometime.
Welcome to Van Meter Street.
Ladies and gentlemen, here we are at the National Convention for the Van Meter 2000 tennis racket. Here we have a nice young lady. Miss, could you, well, first of all, what is your name?
Leslie Stowe.
Okay, we have Miss Leslie Stowe here. And could you tell us how the Van Meter 2000 tennis racket has improved your tennis game?
I've never done this before, just a minute. Well, I like it because it's graphite and it's light. Mm-hmm. And it hits the ball when I swing it. It's not as much effort, so I really like it quite well.
Okay. Well, thank you very much, and we'll see who else we can find. Well, ladies and gentlemen, here we have found a nice young lady who is presently using the Van Meter 2000. Miss, could you tell us a little bit about this new wonder?
I tell you, this thing is just wonderful. I mean, it used to be a time that I could only play, you know, just with one hand, mm-hmm. but now I can take this thing and I can go between my legs, I can go around my back, I can come all the way from the side, and everybody just wondering how I can do it. This is all in the racket, it's the secret. And you know, you really can't tell anybody about it, because, you know, if you tell them, everybody will want to know it. Then you know what happens? You won't be so famous. But now I'm famous. Watch.
Okay, let's see who else we can find. Oh, here's a nice young lady. Excuse me, could you tell me how the Van Meter 2000 tennis racket has improved your tennis game?
Oh, it is wonderfully. Especially since I won Wimbledon and all those other tennis games. And help beat that little girl up right there.
Okay.
Well, thank you. Well, I'll see you last week.
Okay. All right. It's in my pocket.
Ladies and gentlemen, this just is an exciting moment here. We have found the world famous world champion tennis player here, Mr. Bruce Conrad. Mr. Conrad, could you give us a little information about the new Van Meter 2000 tennis racket and how it has improved your game?
Well, the Van Meter 2000 racket is the best racket that I ever played with in my entire career. I played with this racket all over the world. This is the greatest racket of all time.
Well, thank you, sir. I was words from the champion.
The Van Meter 2000, the latest technology in tennis court weaponry. You know what I like about the Van Meter 2000? It's versatility. I mean, you can do forehands, you can do backhands, you can do overhead smashes that will blow your opponent away. You can serve and ace your opponent every time with the Van Meter 2000. And you know what? It doesn't stop there. I mean, you can flip pancakes and pizzas with it. You can use it as a machine gun. All right, you wise guys. You can even... Well, I forgot what else you can do with it, but there's a lot of other things you can do with it. And you can have it for the unbelievably low price of $19.95. Order yours today, the Van Meter 2000.
Hey, Uncle Marvin, what's the key to a great Thanksgiving dinner? A turkey. What if the hot dog sticks?
Show them your kitty cat. Back there. Tell them what you're doing.
I made my kitty for you. And, thank you.
Oh, Douglas and Esther, I see in your future visitors from another world.
We'll see you at Christmas!
Aaron, who were these people?
I don't know.
That one with the long black hair kind of looked like Esther, but I don't know. Aunt Esther, this is for you. Sir, you going to San Diego too?
See.
You have family there?
See.
Do you have are you married?
See.
Oh, you're married, huh? Yeah, I'm married, lady. What's your wife's name?
Sue.
Sue, huh?
See.
What about what's your name there, sir?
Sai.
Sue and Sai, huh?
See.
Do you have any kids?
See.
What's your son's name?
Sai.
You and your son are both named Sai?
See.
Do you have a daughter?
See.
Let me guess, her name's Sue.
See.
Sue and Sue and Sign and Sign, huh?
See.
Sergeant, are you going to see any good visit your parents?
See.
Yeah. What's your father's name?
Sigh.
Sigh. Three sighs, huh?
See.
And what's your mother's name?
Sue.
Sue. Yeah. Well, you and your father and your son are all named Si.
See.
And your wife, your daughter, and your mother are all named Sue.
See.
Do you have any brothers or sisters?
See.
You have a brother?
See.
Let me guess, his name's Si.
See.
You have a sister?
See.
What's her name?
Sue.
Sue.
See.
So you, your father, your son, and your brother all named Si.
See.
And your wife, your daughter, your mother, and your sister all named Sue.
See.
Well, you have any aunts or uncles?
See.
Let me guess, they're all named Si. See and Sue all of them. Well, my train ought to be coming along here anyway.
Train for San Diego, now boarding track 19.
Well, it's been nice talking to you.
See.
Ladies and gentlemen, here we are live at the Lemon Cafe. And here we have its owner and founder, Miss Thelma Lemon. Miss Thelma Lemon, come over here. We're going to put you on national television. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
Ask me
a question. This is the one and only retired tennis champion of the world. And during her retirement year, she has founded the Lemon Cafe.
Oh!
Miss Thelma Lemon, during your tennis career, we understand that you were a frequent user of the Van Meter 2000 tennis racket. We'd like to ask you, how has the Van Meter 2000 improved your tennis game?
It's really improved. It's fine now.
Fine now. Even after retirement, she still uses the Van Meter 2000 for recreation.
Barbie clothes.
Oh, I got them.
They sure do.
Grandma Van Meter. Grandma Thelma, I mean. This is my old man.
Casey!
Poor Katie.
What do you think
of
this, Katie? Oh, there, she's so frustrated.
Why are those legs open?
Here, here,
here.
Look
at
the
little mommy, mommy.
Wow, Ariel.
Dan's taking
the
picture.
Wow. Ariel.
Push her back where it scares me. I'm walking towards her in there. Her character. God, she's like a witch. She got no eyebrows or nothing.
Boy, Jay, I bet you're jealous here, man.
Who is she trying to imitate? Wow.
It's rock singer Marilyn Manson.
Marilyn Manson?
Manson.
You know what it is? Is that the mermaid?
She got black hair.
Yeah. Wow, that's really nice.
Who do we think
we Well, the Barbie dolls from Grandma.
Boy, they make it impossible to get these guys out of there.
Marilyn Manson, doesn't she sing songs like that?
I know what to do.
Will the real Douglas Van Meter please stand up?
Please dial 1-888-VAN-METER. That number once again is 1-888-VAN-METER. Goodbye, Uncle Douglas and Esther, Cynthia, and Courtney.
Bye, Uncle Marvin, Aunt Connie, and Mark.
Bye, everybody.
Goodbye, everybody.
Bye, everybody. I hope you enjoyed this video. It's December 1997. Hope you all have a nice holiday and Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Bye.